Good morning. Happy Easter. Welcome to Mass at St. Michael the Archangel Parish. Our celebrant today is Father Branson. Today we celebrate Easter Sunday. This Mass is being offered for the intentions of the people of St. Michael the Archangel Parish. For more information about our parish or volunteer activities, please head to our website at stmichael77.org or see our bulletin. Please join us next week, Sunday, April 16th at 3 p.m. for the Divine Mercy Holy Hour. Our office will be closed on Monday. Communion service will be on Monday with the rosary at 8 a.m. and the communion service at 8:30. Students, we need your help after Mass to set up. Please see Mr. Andy in the back. It is our custom not to depart from Mass until the choir has finished singing. Our wonderful choir. Very big today. And you don't want to miss their lovely voices. As we prepare for Mass, please let us silence our cell phones and observe a moment of silence. Thank you.
Good morning and happy Easter. And would you please stand and join us in singing the opening songs, Alleluia, He is Risen.
Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Kyrie eleison.
God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached? How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God and advanced, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witnesses, that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of the sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made.
The builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
This is the day the Lord has made.
This is the day.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you are raised with Christ, seek what is above. Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, of not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Your joy and praises known at the best.
Lamb has been sacrificed. Christ our Paschal Lamb has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture, that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My uncle and aunt are sitting in the front row. It's the first time I've had to say hi. First, I got a chance to say hi to them this morning. They came from downtown Mesa. Where did you all park? Just think, you can park anywhere around here and the HOA won't get you. So you get a freebie on that one. You know, this past week, we followed the terrible passion and the death of Jesus in the liturgy, Holy Thursday, Good Friday. And part of our journey through his suffering and death was a challenge we received to identify where we stand on the issue of Calvary. Do we stand with Jesus or against him? Are we Veronica and Simon and the Jerusalem women who helped him on the way? Or are we the howling mob and the hand-washing Pilate and the weak disciples who only heard him? We have moved with Jesus and with that question to the passion and death this past week. What happened yesterday, Holy Saturday? It was a preview of what happens today. Jesus in the tomb didn't stay there. He went to search for our first parents. He went to free them from the sorrow and the captivity, Adam and Eve. He said, "I now command all who are in bondage to come forth, who are in darkness to be enlightened, and all who are sleeping to arise." Up until Jesus' resurrection, the abode of the dead was for everybody. No gates, heaven or hell, were opened. So Jesus went down to roll the stone away from the abode of the dead. The Jews call it Sheol, so that the people could be led to heaven. That there were things they had been waiting for millennia, for him to do. And so he rolled their stone away, and he said, "The enemy led you out of paradise, but I'm not taking you back to paradise that you think of." He He said, "Rise and leave this place. I can lead you to heaven." Now, we must move with Jesus from the tomb, his, to the resurrection. With another question. The Lord has arisen from his tomb. Have we risen from ours? The disciple that is a Christian says to him or herself, "My Lord has arisen and is alive, but have I arisen from the depths of my sins? And am I alive with his grace on this glorious day?" If you and I have not risen from our own tombs, the stone is still there, then the resurrection of the Lord from his tomb has no meaning in time or eternity for us. There are Christians in all of our parishes whose joylessness and gloom contradict their belief in the resurrection. They go about their religious and social lives as though they are being perpetually crushed by the stone at the entrance to Jesus' tomb. So many others continue to live in the tomb of sin, the tomb of drink, the tomb of addiction, the tomb of violence, or the tomb of bad memories, or the tomb of grief, from which they despair of ever coming out. They've grown accustomed to their tombs. They're comfortable in them. They're afraid that somebody might come along and roll back the stone and expose them to the light and the challenge of living a resurrected life. They're comfortable. They don't want change. There are Christians who turn their homes into tombs for their spouses and children because of their selfishness and abuse. There are teens and adults by the hundreds of thousands in the lands of the so-called Christian West who prefer entombment with drink, drugs, racial fear, violence, pornography, immorality of various kinds to the resurrection with the Lord and the real living. They too celebrate Easter, but for some unseen, unknown reason. On this glorious day of the Lord, we are sure in faith that Jesus is alive and well. We will look forward like him and Adam and Eve to the day when we go back to the Father in glory. In looking forward, we are also looking back at what many of us have left behind. Last night, the Easter Vigil, we had three individuals baptized into the Catholic faith. They left behind their old lives. Some of their old lives were not so nice. Some of them was just a little bit of a change. But they left their old lives behind to become part of the resurrected Christ. For the last 2,000 years, we've had Catholic Christians leave their old lives behind. Saints have decided they don't want to be part of the tomb. And so they roll their stones back and they become part of the resurrected life. And that's how they became saints. And their question was, "My Lord lives, do I?" And they have been answered, "Yes, Lord, I have walked with my passion and my pain in solidarity with yours. I've been lifted high above the hills of my sins, and I've emptied my tomb. I too am resurrected, and I am alive and well with you on this great day. So let us roll all of our stones away today and always and come into the light so that we too can say, he is risen and so am I." God bless you. And so I now ask you to stand. What is the response?
I do.
Very good, you remember. It's better than last night. What are you going to look for so that you know when to say I do?
Your hand.
That's only your hand over here. I do this, and you say I do. I'm making it easier on them. Had trouble parking, so they're upset. So I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that no sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Gotta turn the page. Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord? Wait a minute. What about the hand? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
Very good. Almighty God, the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us place our knees before God our Father, rejoicing because Christ has triumphed over death and entered into glory.
For the Holy Father, Pope Francis, that like St. Peter, he may continue to lead the church in witnessing to the joyful truth of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have dedicated their lives to God, that they may look for the things that are in heaven and be Christ's witness in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those unjustly deprived of their freedom, that they may draw fresh hope of freedom from the mystery of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family of God gathered here in Easter joy, that we may bear witness to the risen Christ and reflect him in our lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may rise to eternal life in Christ, especially the holy souls in purgatory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty Father, your beloved Son has risen from the dead, as he promised us. In peace and joy, we present our prayers to you, the same risen Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Come to the river, flowing from the body of Christ.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Food of the earth and work of human hands have become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day above all, the Lord hear more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Most merciful Father, make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which you offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together, servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those holding to the truth and on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants who are living. And all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer the sacrifice of praise, or they offer for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Damian, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command them to be delivered from eternal damnation, and count among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven, To you, God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us. This pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, the sight of your divine majesty. So all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in a sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who are those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share of fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Add ministry, beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon. Through Christ our Lord, then we continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not in our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Saint Michael,
the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And be thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thus in the hell of Satan and all evil spirits, who prowl about the world seeking your ruinous souls. Amen.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, to you, O blessed Joseph,
do we come in our afflictions, and having implored the help of your most holy spouse, we confidently invoke your patronage also. Through that charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embrace the child Jesus, we humbly beg you graciously to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has by his blood, and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most watchful guardian of the Holy Family, defend the chosen children of Jesus Christ. O most loving Father, ward off from us every contagion of error and our own evils. O Lord, most mighty protector, be kind to us and never have to assist us in our struggle for the power of darkness. As once you rescued the child Jesus from deadly peril, so now protect God's holy church from the snares of the enemy and from all adversity. Shield through each one of us by your constant protection. So that, supported by your example and your aid, we may be able to live piously, to die in holiness, and to obtain eternal happiness in heaven. Amen.
Is